Muchas gracias a Andrés Pascual por su amable e interesante conferencia. Yo no sé cómo nuestro próximo invitado, Nuk Schultz, tendrá su equilibrio entre su oso, su tigre y su dragón. Pero lo que sí que sabemos, sabemos que ha estado al frente de la biblioteca de central de Aarhus desde 1987 hasta el año 2017, 30 años. En esos 30 años, Nuk ha conseguido inaugurar una biblioteca que es impresionante, una biblioteca que es la biblioteca central de Aarhus, que ayer me comentaba que Aarhus tiene un significado que es Arv debe ser casa, Rus es río, la casa del río. Pues en Aarhus hay una magnífica biblioteca inaugurada en 2015. Impresionante, que se llama TOC 1. Me temo que el equilibrio entre el oso, el dragón y el tigre de Nuk tiene que ser impresionante para conseguir, después de 30 años de ejercicio de la profesión, marcharse dejando ese magnífico proyecto de biblioteca que habría que conocer in situ. En la actualidad, Nuk está integrado en la gerencia de la IFLA, de la Federación Internacional de Bibliotecarios y de Bibliotecas. Sin más, os dejo con Nuk, que os va a hablar de qué expectativas tienen los usuarios de las bibliotecas. Muchísimas gracias.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for the introduction. And dear colleagues and library friends, what an honor to be invited to speak to so experienced and a clever audience as you are. I'm a bit overwhelmed and humble, of course, related to what you are doing in your daily work. I have to apologize for my complete missing skills in Spanish. So I have to speak in English, and I'm sure that the very competent translators will do their best to give you the common essence of the speak. So thank you to the translators at the absolute top of the room. I have many slides, and they will go very fast. And I would say, relax a little. Look at the pictures. Get some of the speech in your ears from the translators. It's just an experience to show about what a modern library could be. And remember, this is not a recipe. This is one way to do it in a local community. All libraries are depending on their own communities and the opportunities they have in the local area. So decide how your own library should be. This is just an example. Okay. A few words about myself. I was already presented as a former manager in the main library in Aarhus, and I've done the managerial work for 30 years. So when the dock opened in 2015, I decided to leave it in 2017 and retire at that moment, because I think now the work is done for me related to this library. And actually, I'm a member of governing board in IFLA, the International Federation of Library Associations and Institutions. And I know our president will speak to you at the last day of the conference, Gloria Salomon. But this is much about DOC 1 and much about how the library vision for the future could be. It's much about the library in a knowledge society, and with some facts and about the layout and the arrangement in DOC 1. Partnership strategy, not to forget. The slide presentation will be able and visible on SlideShare, and you can download it from SlideShare when it's finished here today. So if you want to go back and see something, maybe translated in Google, etc., it's able for you to access the whole presentation. Just about where is Aarhus in Denmark? It's 430 hours of walking without any pause. So it's about 2,000 kilometers. The city of Aarhus is located in Denmark on Jutland, and it's not only about a main library, it's also about 18 branch libraries in the community. There is 330,000 inhabitants and about 2 to 2.5 million library visits per year, and 5 million loans, including renewing loans. And one of the things is that all libraries are what we call more open, means open hours without any kind of staff. I said all 18 branches and the Doc 1 too. And all libraries offers what we call citizen service at different levels. Citizen service, I'll come back to that in a few minutes. But a little about the library transformation. What is libraries? Libraries is the citizens' driving force for innovation. All people want to change something in their life when they enter a library. And when they enter a library, they meet information, they need knowledge, but they also need other library users, other users with expectations to the library, other very experienced users that are very willing to deal, to share with the knowledge they already have. So the public library is a place where you can find the inspiration, meet new ideas, either or in the own, in the public sphere, or in company with others. Library support people with possibilities to make change in their life. And I said make change in their life. It's not only about a new graduation at the university or something. It could be that you want to be in another mood. You want to listen to some music. You want to hear some poems from a speaker. You want to engage you with some clever people that want to change something in the society, whatever. But people who are going into a library want to change something in their lives. So how do we sketch this future library transitioning to a space for citizens and community connections? The change we are in actually at this moment is just a few words about it. It's going from information that can be found anywhere to what can only be experienced in the library. What I mean when I say information can be found everywhere, all of us more or less have this smartphone and information is with us everywhere. So the library is not only about, as it was formerly, about information and reading. No, the library is about something that only can be experienced in the building, in the library. So the library was formerly a space for media. Now the media is the space as a media. Formerly we got online, now we go on-site. Information was very valuable, now we go to meaning. What happens in the library space is about meaning, and so on. I said that all libraries in Aarhus are integrated with citizen service into libraries, and I think it's a big chance to integrate a part of the reinventing of the society services from citizen service, where you have to show up very much and it's very much depending on communication with a public officer from the local administration. Citizen service is very much on the internet now in Denmark. Up to 90% of all situations can be handled directly on the internet. And who is going to learn the public to use the internet in the in the best way when they are doing themselves in citizen service. The library, of course. The library is the only place that can do this communication, do this training, do this learning. So it brings citizens in contact with the library. Many citizens that don't have been in contact with the library before. And it brings the libraries in close contact with the politicians, because the politicians and the innovators in the city are working to digitize all this different part of the citizen service. So, when we talk about citizen service, it's all about passport, it's about driving license, it's about health insurance, it's about one-stop information to contact to public institutions. That's one of the opportunities the libraries could have in your local community. This is a model for developing the community centers in the private, civic, and public sector and merge them. We call it the mash-up library, this model, because it mashed up with different services that originally is linked to the library or is a part of a library, but it also have meeting rooms for the community. It have some business service. It have maybe health consulting. It maybe have some local archive. It's maybe a job corner, etc., etc., etc. Services that is produced in other organizations, private, civic, or public sector organizations. So what is this about? A library then? Where is the library in this mashup? The library is the glue. The library is the space. There is no other civic organizations, no other public organizations that can do this. There is no other institutions in the society than the library that can mash up all the others. So it's very important to think about the library in the future as a developing community center with different organizations included. When I was talking about open libraries or mentioned open libraries in the introduction, it means in Aarhus that all libraries are open from 7 to 22 all weekdays. Users can log them in by their membership card or their health insurance card, check in and out media, use the internet, the PC, the copy, the printing, use the space for studying, read the newspapers, make study circles, public meetings, etc. They can do nearly everything that could happen in a library, also when the staff is there. There is also more opening hours in the Dock 1, Monday to Friday, from 8 to 10. There is no staff in the space at all. It's only the users and themselves. Then from 10 to 7, there is specialist support, and then again from 7 to 9, there is no staff at all in the building. And from 9 to 10, the meeting space is still open without any kind of staffing. We're talking about a library that have visitors daily, about 4,000 visitors. And I can tell you that exact in this moment, there is 816 persons in the library using the different library functions. So it's not a very slow-working, non-used library. It's heavily used. 800 is more than we are inside here. That's using the library in Aarhus, just at this moment. And of course, there is open Saturday and Sundays too. The Knowledge Society. What is about the Knowledge Society? The Knowledge Society is about that we are going from libraries for books and medias. That was what was the key word in the industrial society. We have some pictures here about the libraries for books and medias. Very, very impressive building, especially the building on the right one is in Holland, and the left one is from Aarhus formerly before we moved to the new Dock 1. And in the industrial society, we had to move from industrial society to networked and knowledge society libraries. That's libraries for people. That's not libraries for medias. And it looks like this. People do something with the space. We have a model to discuss this change, to help us to discuss the change, where we have the four zones in the knowledge society. I'll come back to this model later on, but it's just to say we have some models to discuss, cover this discussion, because we need this, because when we are talking about people and what people want to do in the space, in the library, we also move from discussions of collections and medias, etc., into what are people doing in the building, instead of where do we have the media and how do we present them. Modern libraries and modern management is also about optimizing the most cost-effective solutions we can get. We are talking about tax-paid money, and there is some who pay this tax, and we have to respect this, that this money is maybe more valuable as money in the commercial or the business world. So we have to be cost effective, and in Aarhus, all buying media and all about selecting media to all the libraries, the public libraries, are tendered out to external suppliers. Media profiles are made on all 19 libraries as guideline to the suppliers. So a new media is ready to circulation with FID tags, security, etc., when it's delivered to the library. There is no process in selecting this media and no work to do them ready for use in the library. Access, registration and catalog, control for payment, etc., are done when the media hit the sorting system for first time. There is no staff involved in that. The people who use the library is using things like this to return the books or return the media. But the next thing is that all medias are floating between the 9 libraries. That means there is no media that belongs to a specific library. Library users are checking out and checking in by themselves, and the media sorting system behind it decide when they checking in a book where it should be ending up, depending on titles presented in the library already or space to on the shelves, a library profile. So the library system knew all shelves in all 19 libraries and how much is inside a shelf at this moment. So it will never return a media to a shelf where there is not a space to replace it. The scrapping of media happens when titles haven't been circulated in 24 months, 2 years. That's about cost effectiveness in the public libraries. This is the sorting system that do all the work around sorting to all 19 libraries. Some professors at the library school in Denmark made a model for a public library in urban development. That's also important for library managerial work to know where and how do the library interact with the city, the community around it. And they took a trip around the world and find out there is 3 elements a new library offer to a city. So the library is in the center here, and this is what a library gives back or offers the city it is in. It's a place, icon, placemaker, catalyst. It's a space to open-minded meeting space, public domain, and it's an experience space. And it's about relations. A new library or a library means that there will be partnerships and creative alliances and creative entrepreneurs linked to the library. These 3 elements is the core element of a modern library related to a city. The new libraries around the world are signs or symbols on development and innovation in the society. In Aarhus, absolute, but in many other places in both in Europe and other continents, that libraries is symbols of city development and is driving cities forward. It adds new stories about the towns. All towns in the world need new stories about themselves. And it arguments for new city engagements. Just examples from new libraries, Amsterdam, placed in the middle of the city, a part of total reintroduction of the middle city in Amsterdam. Birmingham, at the same, in the middle of the city, complete brand new library with some kind of symbols about the heavy industry for trains in the former Birmingham city. Helsinki, it's going to open 7 days from now. A brand new library on the Finnish Independence Day, and it's placed absolute opposite to the parliament in Finland. This is a new way of thinking of democracy. All the new libraries are signalizing democracy. And it's the libraries, museums, the cultural institutions that establish the vision about democracy. It's not parliaments. Oslo will open in 2 years. A new part in the middle of Oslo. Beside it, the new opera and a building that's just under the start of construction, a new museum of art, of modern art in Oslo. This is the three cultural institutions that's a picture in the future of Norway. That's very important that libraries are part of this kind of it. This is the situation in Aarhus in 2013, 5 years ago, when we were building. You see the cranes here, and that's the building of the Dock 1, that racing there. At the end of the river, where Aarhus is placed, the river that runs out to the sea, exactly around the Dock 1. The project elements in Dock 1 is a main library and a citizen service running up to about 18,000 square meters. And then we have a partner network contracted out 10,000 square meters. There is some automatic parking space for 1,000 cars, two new urban harbor squares, a railway center for light rail, and there is some other traffic regulation and playground, etc., around the library, approximately for 300 million euros. Just some pictures from the inside of the library, just to start to show you how this library is in combination with the surroundings. The visions of Dock 1, and now we are again in the field of making advocacy and politics around the library, is the space for cooperation, a place for dialogue, knowledge, ideas, and inspiration. Open informal learning space, a unique place for children and families. This was what the politicians decided that Dock 1 should be about. This is not only some very visionary library staff members think about the library, or what some from the public community think about it. They think it too, but this is what the politicians made. Not a word about media or books. But books are very important. They are part of doing all these activities. But book is not the focus, it's the human activities that are in focus. So in some ways, what we were working with in the Dock 1 is that users are taking the control. I'll give you some examples. Again, this model about what are the different spaces in the library. The inspiration space, the learning space, the meeting space, the performative space. And remember, you can go back to SlideShare after this 3 day long meeting and find the model again on the internet. It's about what happens in the different spaces. Experience is discovering the participation of the creation. It doesn't mean that all libraries should complete cover all these spaces, but this spaces is a way to discuss how should our actual library and our community work with the users, because that goes from thinking about media and books into what the users are using the library for. So just some pictures about things we already know that happens in many libraries about events, individual concentration, digital media, staging, picture books, reading aloud, and exploring, yes. And when we are talking about learning space and discovering, we talk about teaching, we talk about courses, informal learning, consultations, guidance, access to knowledge, training, one-to-one, etc. All these activities that we know are in the learning space. There is also a participation space, the meeting space, where our users are involved in discussions, meetings, being together, debates, etc. And we have the performative space, where creation, innovation, etc. is very important, where workshops, edutainment, experiment, workshops, etc. take place, gaming, mega spaces, etc. All pictures from Doc 1, this. So a modern library must act adaptive and innovative and support spaces. Libraries are changing from storing books to supporting citizens' needs. Innovation spaces for local communities. This is just the picture or the drawing of the library with the different levels in the library. I think three statements for working with change, working with building construction, etc., could be useful. Last responsible minute for decisions. Don't make a plan where you do all the decisions, up to 80% of the decisions before you start learning from the project you are in. That's a huge failure to work with. Do the decisions in the last responsible minute, where you know most about what you're working with. Work with inclusion and participation from different group of people, and work with interdisciplinary cooperation. Means that you involve other skills than you have in the library already. The right team at the right time. Just pictures and words from the process where we build up the idea of the Doc 1, involving the staff in co-creation and the citizens in discussions. This is prototyping with the staff, where they picture a lot of things about how did they want the new library to be. This is prototyping with screens. They worked a week about how a library in the future should be. We make a movie out of this. You can find it on the internet and YouTube. And it was the first time that the architectures had seen anybody taking children serious, related to what children want in the future. And we asked our architects to get involved with this and to get some answers from what they were doing related to this. A lot of public consultations were part of it, co-creation with the staff, and just a figure about cooperative design processes. Where do you want to have external involvement? Where do you want to have internal involvement? Will it be very included, or will it be for knowing what way, what direction are we going into? Also about the citizen service in the building, that's fully integrated. So new ways of defining the functionality could be that flexibility is the functionality. All architects hate this. Maximize unprogrammed spaces mean that you have free spaces you can program after what demands you meet at the moment. Leave the media and the media formats as the focus point for organizing the space and focus on human needs. So this is just about the interior plan. I will switch very quickly through this, just pictures about the interior plan, because time is running. This is all pictures from the adult section. Some were maybe laughing. This is a user, very well-known user, sleeping. It's okay to sleep in a library if you need to have a little sleep. I think it's very okay. She is homeless. The level two about the family and children section, examples just that from different situations. It was a key word for our interior plan for the family children area, that the family and the children, or children's elder persons, should be together. And that can last up to 12 years. So our section for family children is up to 12 years. When you are 12 years, you want to be on your own, not depending on a family member or a school teacher or whatever. You want to be on your own. So the rest of the library is an opportunity for people when they have fulfilled 12 years. This is just pictures from the different activities. There is more than 30 different activities for children and grown up to being together with in the area. Of course, there are mistakes on the way, so we had to rearrange part of the interior between the citizen service, the information square, etc. We have to see about our living room. The intention idea of it wasn't clear enough to be used. We have different user groups in some zones of the library that's conflicting. So of course there are mistakes when you design a building like this. One of the important things is about the relation, the partnerships and the creative alliance. And we built a catalog for how to make partnerships with external organizations, building cooperation with the users and the society, founded on partnership strategy. Everybody should have benefits from partnering. So we identified some cornerstones of partnerships in DOC 1 and invited different kind of partners to fulfill it. I know the time is up, but I also know you have 30 minutes for coffee. That's maybe too much, so I'll take the first five of them. So I'm between you and the coffee now. the new space for democracy activities is this is about a parliamentary situation in Denmark. We had a public voting about some of our way to interact with the European community. And the national TV and the parliament want to have a 24 hours hearing in the building with public consultations, etc. The other picture here is one of the journalists in Denmark that would come and tell us how the next 25 years of world history would be. I don't think he is the only person in Denmark that could choose a title like that, the next 25 years world history. 600 persons showed up without any kind of announcement except Facebook. At the best summertime, the first summer day in Aarhus at all, I was between the 100 that was over 30 years. The 500 was under 30 years. So don't say anything about democracy that it doesn't exist, etc. There was a lot of scenes in the library. There was a lot of lab activities, maternity leave for both fathers and mothers, maker fair activities. And the benefit is that the citizens have more programs and services, quality, diversity, target-oriented activities that they want. So the program figures is that the first year there was more than 2,000 program activities in DOC 1, including events, festivals. 10% of them are made by partners without any support from the library. 50% are done in cooperation between partner organizations and library staff, and 40% are done by staff members. And more than 100 partners have signed up a partner contract with the DocMon activities. And that's important when we are talking about how the future will implement the library. We also developed a toolkit for how the library staff could get in contact with the citizens in the library and outside the library, not at least. And this is just figures from the first opening year. And of course, there were critic comments too. I mentioned some things, but they also talked about missing books. All the books are there, but the space is too much bigger, so the shelves are not so close, so they don't see the public that there are the same books as there was in the former library. So what I would say is that users are taking the control now in the library. And this is just to announcement, because Gloria Salmon is talking on the third day, and she will talk about the international advocacy program, I'm sure, about the United Nations sustainability goals, where also the libraries and their work with the local communities are a very, very important part of this. Of course, also related to literacy, etc. And she will also talk about the vision and the future for IFLA, where some of the same thing, equal and free access, supporting literacy, learning and reading, serving our communities, and collaboration and partnership will be mentioned. So a strategy for change in libraries need to address the need for rethinking the library, the need for a fusion between physical and virtual library, developing partnerships, focus on collaborative innovation, use of design thinking, getting new skills into the library and promote learning in the organization, and force users to dismiss the book as a library brand. Force users to dismiss the book as a library brand. That's maybe the hardest part of the work. So the library paradigm for future is user-centered focus, user collaboration, user needs-based services, user-involved development of the library, and library services that support the users in their wishes for make changes in their lives. And you find the presentation on slides here. In the end, an announcement. Every second year, there is a library conference in Aarhus in Dock 1 called Next Library. And it's next year, so it's Next Library 2019. It's the beginning of June, and if some of you want to attend, follow the webpage for Next Library 2019, and don't hesitate to announce your interest when the tickets are sold in, I think, beginning of January, because it sold out very fast. Thank you.